All right, let's now talk about the cross-entropy loss for multiple classes. So in Unit 3, we talked about logistic regression, which works for 0 and 1 class labels. And we used the binary cross-entropy loss in Unit 3. Now we upgrade this to work with multiple classes. So in the previous 3 videos, we saw how we can upgrade logistic regression models to softmax regression models. Now we need to talk about the loss function. However, coupled to the loss function is also the encoding of the class labels, as we will see. So in this video, we are going to talk about the cross-entropy loss and the one-hot encoded class labels that we need as the input for the cross-entropy loss. So why do we actually need a loss function? Why do we really care about cross-entropy? Yeah, as we covered in the previous unit, we need the loss function in order to compute the derivatives of the loss with respect to the weights, which we then need to update the weights. So here we need the loss function to kind of like get an estimate of how wrong the model is in its predictions. And we can use that to compute the gradients or the partial derivatives in order to update the weights so that the model can make better predictions. So what we see here is the computation graph for logistic regression that we covered in Unit 3, again with the partial derivatives that we computed there. Don't worry, we won't be computing more partial derivatives now, because now that we learned about automatic differentiation, we also know that we don't have to worry about them when we implement things in PyTorch. However, we do have to talk about the loss function. So previously we had the binary cross-entropy loss. So that's the loss that we talked about in Unit 3. Again, we are not going over individual terms here, because yeah, we did do that to a great extent in Unit 3 already. However, it's worth highlighting the summation term here again, which sums the loss over multiple training examples. So if we have a data set with n training examples, we sum the loss over all of these n training examples. And again, just for reference, A corresponds to the activation value. In the case of logistic regression, it's the logistic sigmoid activation. So why is the class label, of course? Since we only had a binary classification task in Unit 3, the class labels were either 0 or 1. And what you can see here now is the multi-category cross-entropy loss that we need for our softmax regression model so that it can deal with more than 2 classes. So first, again, we have a summation term here. And the summation term is again over the multiple training examples. This is exactly the same summation term we used before when we computed the binary cross-entropy loss. Yeah, but in contrast to the binary cross-entropy, we also have a second summation term here that sums over all the class labels that we have. So we can have up to k class labels here. Yeah, and similar as before, for the binary cross-entropy, we use y to refer to the class labels. However, here y also has the subscript k, which refers to the class label index. However, this notation requires that we apply the one-hot encoding to the class labels. So here, the values for y are still expected to be 0 and 1. And we will then see how we can get that from a classification task that has multiple class labels. So we will now go over the one-hot encoding that we need to get the class labels into the right form that we can then use with this equation. So assume we are working on a classification problem where we have 4 possible labels, 0, 1, 2, and 3. Yeah, now on the left-hand side, assume we have now different training examples corresponding to these 4 different class labels. So the first training example has class label 0, the second training example has class label 1, and the third training example has class label 3. And of course, the fourth training example has class label 2. And now we are going to convert this into the one-hot encoded class label form. So with this one-hot encoding, we are now changing the values from 0, 1, 2, 3 into a form where we only have zeros and ones. So the one-hot encoded form means essentially that for each training example, we have one hot value. That's the value 1. And all the other values for the training examples are 0. Let's now see how we can map these different class labels into this one-hot encoded form. So if we have 4 class labels, 0, 1, 2, and 3, and we have a training example with class label 0, the class label index 0 will be 1. For the second training example, which belongs to class 1, we have this one hot value in the second index position. And for the third training example, where we have class label 3, we will have this index 1, or the one hot index, in the fourth position. And then lastly, for the fourth training example, which has class label 2, we have then the hot index, or the hot position, at position 3. And now you have seen how the one-hot encodings look like. And they actually plug into the Y here, the placeholder Y. So for a single training example, we only have one value in the columns that has the value 1, and all the others are 0. So if we have 0 times log something, it's going to be 0. So for each training example, we only have one value that is 1. And that's the case then when this expression here, y log something, matters. But if this looks complicated to you, don't worry. In the next part, we are going to walk through the computation of this loss step by step with a simple code example, which I think also helps clarifying all these necessary steps. But for now, just assume you learned about the one-hot encoding, and we learned that this one-hot encoded value, the 0 or 1, plugs into this variable y. So taking one step back in the logistic regression case for binary classification, we said we have either a 0 or a 1 for the value of y. Just suppose this value here is 1. So for the first case, we have y equals 1, and if y equals 1, that means that 1 minus 1 equals 0. So the thing here now on the right-hand side will also cancel out, because 0 times something is 0. Now the same thing happens when we use the multi-category cross-entropy loss here at the bottom. We have one case here for each training example where we have a 1, and all the other cases are 0. So they will cancel out this expression here on the right, where we have y times log times the activation. Again, this was a lot of information, and I just showed you where we plug in the different values, 0 and 1, for the class label. And we talked about how we can convert an integer class label array into the one-hot encoded form. However, we haven't even computed any actual values, though, for the loss. But we are going to do that in the next part, which I think will help clarify a lot of the concepts we just covered here.